Hi, I'm Jamie, and welcome to Teachers Tech. Today, I want to show you how to record your very own macro in Microsoft Excel. If you've never heard of macros, or maybe you thought they were too advanced to use, I'm going to show you in this beginner's tutorial how they could be used by anyone. Let's get started on these step-by-steps on how to create your very own macro in Microsoft Excel. So to start with, let me run this macro here that I already created, and we're going to go through and create this same one. I have a button here that I'm going to click and it's going to run. So let's go ahead and do this. Right away, in a second, it goes through, it created a chart and it did some formatting for me, all with that little click. Now, the whole idea of using macros is it makes things a lot more efficient. If you have that same task that you have to do over and over and over again, so let's say in this example here, maybe the boss gives you a monthly sales report and you have to do certain things like formatting or creating a chart. If you go ahead and create the macro once, every time it comes to you, you can just click the button and it's done in a second. So it just saves you time with those repetitive tasks. So now let's go ahead and find out where do you even start with. You might be wondering, where do you even go to in Microsoft Excel to record macros? Now I'm going to show you a couple of different ways. At the very bottom of my workbook here, notice I have this icon. This is record a macro right here. So if I go ahead and just hover over it, you can see no macros are currently recording. But if I click it, it would start. If I right click right beside it, right here is I have it turned on. You might not have it turned on. So if I uncheck this, notice it's not there anymore. I like to have that quick access to it. The other way to access it is to add it up top to your tabs. And to do that, if I go into any place in the ribbon and just right click, I'm going to go customize the ribbon. I'm going to just move over to this side under my main tabs and scroll down a little bit, and I'm looking for developer. I'm going to check that and hit OK. So now if I look across at the tabs, if I click on developer and look at this, I have the ribbon in here that's dedicated for these different items, and it's record macro is what we're going to be using. If you want to follow along with today's workbook, it is down below in the description. You can click on it, download it, and we can create our macro together. We're going to be creating some very simple macros here today in Microsoft Excel. At the very beginning, I showed you one click where it did the formatting and created the chart all at once. I'm going to break this down a little bit more and we're going to make two macros out of this. Here's my first tip for you. Start with simple tasks before moving on to more complex ones. And we're going to start with simple formatting here. So I'm going to go up and click record macro. And what is it do I want to call this? Naming is really important because inside this workbook, you could have multiple macros and you just don't want it to be called macro 1, 2, 3. You need to be able to recognize it with meaningful names. So for me right now, I'm just going to call this format because I won't have too many macros in here. I could create a shortcut key for it. If I put a letter after it, then I could just hit control in that letter and it's going to be stored in this workbook. I'm going to just hit OK. And right now my macro is being recorded. I can go ahead and stop it up here, or I could hit the square down here to stop this macro as well. Now, what's the first thing that I want to have happen? Well, let's say I want to insert a new row. So that's being recorded. And I want to write monthly sales in here. So just like this. And I'm going to go for my next step. It's going to be to just go through here. I'm going to go over to my home and I'm going to merge and center this. Now I can add some cell styles to this. And let's say I'm going to accent this with this one. And I even want this to be bold. And we'll go through and I'm going to give this also a format here as well. And it will just make this one orange. And I like the bold again. Now I have some tips here for you. So when I want to say, let's say I want January all bolded, I'm going to go ahead and just select with my mouse and hit bold. Now this isn't the proper way to do this because when I show you when we run the macro, I'm going to show you what happens when I highlight it like that. But what you should be doing is if I just go to here and I'm going to use my control shift and I'm going to hit the down arrow to select. And this time I'm going to format it with my dollar signs and let's say bold as well. So we have some formatting here. I'm going to go now just down below here and hit the stop it. So as soon as I stop it, I have a macro. I'm just going to move over to the developer back again. And if I look at the macro right here, notice I have this one called format. If I screwed up on it or something, and if I didn't want it, I could go to delete, or notice I have the options of edit as well. But I think this will work for me here. Now, I'm going to go ahead. We have February here. I'm going to make a copy of this. I'm just going to hold Control down and drag because we're just going to be running this macro a few times. Now, if I go here, I'm going to run this. So how do I run this? I can click on macro. Remember, we haven't made the button yet. I'm just going to go and click run. So now look at this. So notice how I said a couple different ways. Look at February here. It stopped right at, it's not bolded here, but this column is. In this one, I just selected the data range in here. In this one, I used the control shift and I put down arrow on it. So this was dynamic because this list over here was shorter than this list here. So it's important to be using the control shift in the arrows when you're selecting, because if they're not matching up these different, maybe you have more rows, or if you have more columns, then this way it's going to be dynamic and it will adapt. Let's move over to our copy here, and we're just going to add a button. So when we click on it, it's going to perform the macro. I'm going to just make one more copy, hold control when we come back and add the charting to this. Now, to add a button, make sure you're under developer here. We're going to go to the insert. This is the button form control. I'm going to check this and go and draw it. I'm going to leave everything here. So this is what the macro is going to be connected to. I'm going to hit OK. So at this point, do I want it to be called button 5? I can go and change this. So if I was just going to call this format like this, as soon as I click this now, it will perform the macro. So it's very easy to add those buttons. Before we add our chart in with the macro, I want to talk about how to edit a macro. And in this case, you know where I made the mistake where it says January and it's not bolded to these ones here. I want to be able to correct that. So I'm going to go to my macros here, and this is the one that I want to edit. I'm just going to go and select edit. This opens up VBA and it shows me this is our macro that we created the coding for it. Now, what went wrong with this one? If I take a look at it, it says this is where that I'm putting it to be bold, and it's picking the range A3 to A10 select. And then down here, it says when I did it correctly, notice that it says range D3 select, and then it has this line right here. What I'm going to do is actually copy this line, and I'm going to go back up here and hit just enter, and I'm going to paste it in right in here. And now I'm going to go and change this to just A3. So it looks very similar. Now it's selecting that A3 and it's going to go down and be able to select everything in here. So it's just a little edit here. Let's go ahead. Now I'm just going to close this out and we'll go back and let's go and we'll just run it one more time. Notice when I do run it again, what happens? This time it all becomes formatted in here, but when I do run it a second time, this changes here. It added another one, but you can always go back and delete. But on any future ones now, with that edit that we did, these will be all be bolded. But I'll do another tutorial talking more about VBA and how to do more edits in that. But let's move over to January now. Let's go ahead and start our second recording of a macro. I'm going to click record again. This one is going to be called chart, and we're going to put a shortcut. We'll do a control M. I'm going to go and hit OK. What is the area? I'm going to select product category. This is where I'm going to use my control shift and down. And now I'm going to use my control shift and right for my dynamic selection. I'm going to go to insert up on the tab. What chart do I want? I think a combo will work best. I'm going to select this one right here. Do I want a title? What do I want for format? I'm not going to change things too much. I'm just going to go ahead and click off chart title and leave everything else the same. Now I'm going to go ahead and just stop my macro from being recorded. Let's move over to February and let's run it and see what happens. So if I go up to my developer, look for my macros, here's my chart, let's hit run. And here we have the chart instantly placed in here. So now do we want to have another button for this? So if I go over to this one where I already had the format button, I can go and insert another button. And this time I'll just place it right underneath. This is going to be chart, and I hit OK. Change my name on this one. We'll just call this one chart. So we have two different macros. When I click this, now I have my chart added here as well. So I can bring this into the picture or wherever I want to have it. So it's some simple ways to add some macros, breaking it down step by step. Let's talk about how you save this now. So you've set up these macros, you have January, February, now your boss gives you March and you can create a new sheet and copy paste it and then run your macros because they're based on this workbook that you have. When you go ahead and save this, I'm just going to go to File and we'll go to Save As. I want to point out that when we look at the file types here, I'm going to drop down. We need to make sure we save this as Excel macro enabled workbook. So at this point, you can keep the same name if you want. I'm going to do that and I can hit Save. So this will save it as a macro enabled workbook that these macros, I'll be able to open them back up again and then copy and paste the information that I have for the next month, quickly click on one of those buttons and run the macro and get my job done in a hurry. So I hope this helped you with an explanation of how to use macros and why you'd want to use macros in Microsoft Excel. Let me know what else you're looking to learn. Thanks for watching this week on Teachers Tech. I'll see you next time with more tech tips and tutorials.